finished work like 2.5 hours ago and there's still so much daylight left. What is good, everybody? Jossie here and in, what's the, hey brother, how you doing? What's up everybody? Jossie here and in today's video, we're gonna have an honest conversation about how I've been more organized, along with talking about how becoming more organized has helped me become a better developer. Also, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. It helps out with the algorithm a lot. And subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Before we continue this video, I wanna give you all an update on the giveaway. Shout out to Coleman T for winning the Keychron K2 V2. And also thank you to Keychron for partnering with me on this giveaway. There was so much engagement in that desk setup video. I'm just so grateful for that. And since there was so much engagement and so many comments, I'm gonna be sure to do this again in the future. And don't forget to follow me on IG where I make more micro content, more lifestyle content if you're into that kind of stuff. I started a new role remotely, which is new to an extent because my last job, I worked in office for about 4 months and then I worked remotely for about a year. And since I'm more senior and I'm working remotely, I wanna be sure that I am as organized as possible because that can help me become a better developer. And on top of that, I'm trying to become more organized with my actual life because it's very hard to balance being a full-time software engineer, let alone remote on a new team, new company, you know, totally different city that's way more fast paced than where I currently live and grew up in, along with balancing that with YouTube and just life. Ultimately, being more organized comes down to accountability. And I'm gonna show you some really cool features that Notion has to offer that can keep track of your progress. That way you can be accountable to the projects you started, especially if you're someone like me who starts something but never finishes it. The only thing I really start and complete consistently outside of my full-time job as a software engineer are my YouTube videos. I'm really excited to be working with Notion, and one of the main reasons why is because I already use their product, and it always feels incredible when I work with a brand whose product I already love or service I already use before we even start working together. So it really feels like a partnership more than anything else. If this is your first time hearing about Notion, it is an all-in-one tool for your whole team. Notion is an all-in-one workplace that gives you the ability to write, plan, and organize your life, projects, and teams. I've used apps like Trello, Asana, and some other apps, and Notion is pretty much all those apps combined with more. Later in the video, I'll discuss my process of learning a new programming language and how using Notion can improve your efficiency as a developer, along with tracking your project's progress. Notion also has templates that help you solve problems unique to you. So if you're a developer like myself, learning a new programming language and want to write technical docs, keep track of sprints, and embed helpful resources, you can do that very easily with Notion's engineering templates, code snippets that you can actually toggle between different programming languages, which is incredible, and media bookmarks that remind you of iPhone widgets. So the first part of this video I'm gonna show you is how I've organized my life through Notion. And later in the video, I'll show you how Notion has helped me become a better developer through their incredible notes and doc systems that keep you organized. The first workspace is my homepage, and one thing you'll notice right away when using Notion is how incredible this user experience is. Notion allows you to add and customize icons for each page, along with adding and customizing the cover page. My homepage consists of a personal stuff page. I'm not the best person at labeling things, so just bear with me. I also have a Spark creativity and inspiration page that really is just a workspace that allows me to easily access social graphic design sites and photography pages I find inspiration from. To design your page to look like this, you just add some text as an H1, H2, or H3, and then add a divider underneath the header, then add your different pages to link to. Notion automatically gives you pages templated out, which makes it very easy to get started. In my personal page, I have a Netflix list of shows I want to watch and shows that I've already watched, which is empty because I just started adding to this list. I actually should change it to shows that are available and shows that are coming soon. So if you want to add a show, you simply click the plus to add a block and add a URL that links to the specific show or movie you like to add to your list. This is a powerful feature that Notion offers. When I mentioned earlier that they give you pages already templated out, this is an example of that. And all you have to do is just click the block and boom, there's a field for you to enter in your URL to create that beautiful looking media widget. Quick Notes is really just for me to have a page for reminders for like to-do list items that I don't want to forget but can easily get overlooked, like paying a parking ticket. Also, reminders are useful because sometimes I forget that I have to pay a parking ticket or I need to give someone a call, along with setting reminders for when I want to complete tasks like this video. So to create a reminder, you simply create another block, add some text, and then you use the at symbol, which will give you this drop down with different options. So you select a date, and then after that, you can actually click on the date and then select choose include time, and you can change the time at the top of the overlay. As a developer, I'm a huge fan of Kanban boards, so I can drag and drop items into different swim lanes. There's something about dragging and dropping an item into done that just feels euphoric. I've used this workspace more than any other, as you can imagine, to be more efficient with my system of creating videos so I can finish videos on time more often and consistently release videos. Also, this is a great way to keep track of all the content I've made so I can look back and say, hey, I created all these videos this year and this is the amount of effort it took. It's very easy to create a work item. You just click the plus, then expand the item, give it a title, add a new task, property. You can mention someone if you're working on a team. And then don't forget to add an icon, because that will make your workspaces much easier to read, especially when the icons correlate to that specific page or workspace. The nice thing about Notion is that any item can become a workspace, so I can create a workspace for a YouTube video that's also an item in a Kanban board. When it comes to learning a new programming language, you absolutely have to understand the main concepts before you can really start building any meaningful applications or tools. I'm definitely guilty of skimming over tutorial documentation, and I think a big part of that is because I never had an organized system to learn where I can host all the information I learned, because let's face it, it's impossible to remember everything when it comes to a new programming language. I'm a big believer in that if you jot things down, that will help you understand difficult concepts a lot easier. I know I don't do that consistently, which is why I've been using Notion so adamantly. The past few weeks, I've really honed in on creating meaningful Notion workspaces to help me understand React. I've used a combination of pages, progress tables, and visuals through coding snippets and URL embeds to understand fundamental React components like state management, rendering, and style components. If you take the workspaces away, where would all that information I learned go? How would I know how much I've progressed? Where's the evidence that I've had any progression or really learned anything? Especially when you step away from a programming language and you don't have any workspace you can go to view your progression and all the things you've learned, you kind of have to start from zero. I've personally been using this feature to help me stay on track and not to give up on side projects. In my React Projects Progress workspace, you can see a project completion progress table at the top that is in relation to my coding task table through the relation and roundup properties. Also, I'll be sure to link Notion's video that shows you how to build this for the sake of time. This feature has made a huge difference because I can now visualize the progression I've made on React Projects, in which I hope to complete this simple Pomodoro timer by the end of the week, and 5 side projects by the end of the year. So that concludes this video. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it at all, or if you're simply just still here. Also subscribe for more content like this, and I'd really enjoy for you all to become a part of this wonderful community. Be sure to hit that notification bell as well so you can know right away when I release a video. Thank you to Notion for sponsoring this video. This was a really fun video to make, and I think it's showing that I've at least try to become more mature and more professional when it comes to software development. And as always, have a wonderful, blessed rest of your week. I'll see you all soon. Peace.